Hi, Cindy J from Green Bay. I'm here today with a Tihu haul to share with you. I know all the things about Tihu bad and, you know, wasteful, whatnot, but gosh, it's still so darn fun. And I had a credit to use up, actually a pretty good sized credit because I had returned some items. So I had about a $90 credit to use. And so this haul here is around $95 or so dollars here that I have to take a look at. And the fun thing about Tihu is it is always like Christmas since it takes about 2 weeks to get your orders. So it's kind of like, oh, what did I order again? Excuse me. And great hack with Tihu. I have to say, their return policy, I mean, it is pretty decent in that, you know, it's a free return. You just get your label printed off. I go to the UPS store since it's just on the way to other places that I run errands. And I find that if you just keep this bag that it comes in, it's handy while you're trying to decide whether or not you're going to have any returns. And then you can just reuse their own bag. So that's what I've been doing because I'm confident I'm going to have some returns to make with this order because I purchased quite a few clothes and some work clothing, in particular some stuff that I was hoping to wear in spring, and I really do want to get back to working, so I am needing some professional wear to get my wardrobe built back up again. So yeah, I mean, not that Tihu is the best, but you got to start somewhere, right? So at any rate, we'll get to that. But in here, what I have is this here is a light bar. So in the process of trying to reorganize my clothes and everything, I have an armoire, but it's really dark. And so I thought this light bar would be a good addition to it to help me see my clothes better, because the armoire itself is dark in color and it's put in a spot where there's not a lot of light outside of, you know, midday. So I'm hoping that this will be the answer. This was actually kind of an expensive item. It was like $10, I want to say. My understanding is that the way that it works is that you charge it up and then it's a motion sensor. I mean, it's very light. It feels cheap, not gonna lie. It feels cheap for what I paid for it, but we'll see how it works. But it's got these neat little magnets. That way you can just put it, you know, it's double-sided. You can put it to wherever you want to have it. But I am looking forward to getting this charged up a little bit and seeing how it works, because play with that later. So $10 light bar, but I'm a little nervous about this one because, again, it's so incredibly light in weight. I don't know if I have much hope for the quality of it. And then what I have here are a couple of smaller light bars because I guess I wanted to see, you know, the difference between the two. I do have two shelves. So this one being a two-pack, I'm hoping that this one works well, that I can use one for each level. Or, you know, if necessary, I'll just have to put these two together. But see, now these feel like much better quality. And I think that this one was in the ballpark of like $10 or $11. I know that these light bars, I remember feeling like they were a bit expensive. But, you know, for Tihu items especially. But because I had the credits to use anyway, and some light bars for this project was something that I wanted anyway, it just seemed to make sense. So, yeah, again, these feel a little bit better quality. The same deal, got to charge them up the USB with the motion sensor. So we'll see how that works out. What I'm nervous about is that the batteries won't charge very well after a few uses, and then after a couple of times, I don't want to have to be taking it down and plugging it back in, you know, even on a weekly basis, you know, if I've got to do it once a month. So I am, that's where I am a little bit iffy too on these rechargeable ones because you never know how long they are going to keep that charge for. And sometimes just using good old batteries can be reliable as well. So we'll see how they work out, but the light bars will be going back if I don't like them. And so far, like I said, not high hopes for that first one. Oh, and then these little guys, these are just some fairy lights, and they were extremely cheap. Just those little, ones that they're good usually for maybe 20, 30 hours total. They have just the little cheap, battery and the little switch on and off, no timer or anything like that. But these are very fun for arts and crafts projects, and I think it was like a quarter each that I got them for. So I'm gonna just put them in my bag for projects down the road because I was thinking, again, I keep thinking about my gingerbread houses because I put so much work into them and didn't get to display them. So this fall, I'm very excited to get them all set early on, and these are going to be some of the lights that I put around it, but getting a little ahead of myself. But again, the price was really good as I was browsing, and I wanted to get that credit used up. So I'm going to save that for my potential returns because, I mean, even with the light bars, unless all of, the two pack and that long single one are awesome and I can't live without them. At least one of them is going to be going back, if not the both of them. I just don't know. Okay, so this one here, this was a bit of a splurge. This here is $20. It is a red suit, basically. It's red. It's very bright red, and it's that sort of a little bit scratchy-ish material. I mean, again, you get what you pay for. Kind of a cute little top here. I guess I'll have to see how it looks on. I mean, obviously, these outfits always look so much better on the models. I mean, even the photoshopping, if anybody who's looked at Temu, I mean, if you're looking at this video, you've probably been on the Temu site. And the photoshopping, it's so obvious. I mean, they don't even the arches that they have in the models' backs, they don't even try to make believe. So yes, you gotta be prepared for, managing expectations, as they say. A little on the wrinkly side, so I'll have to see if just spraying it with some wrinkle releaser would be okay with this if I work out. Oh, and I like how the back has some stretch to it, yet it still has a zipper. So that'll be interesting. It is a long skirt, but because I am short, I mean, yeah, it's gonna be down to almost my ankles, but because it's meant for work, I suppose that's okay too. So yes, this was my big outfit. I'll have to think about it, of course, after trying it on. So we shall see about the red suit. Normally, I always go for black everything because, let's face it, black is easy. But I thought, oh, wouldn't it be nice to have, a little red suit? Wouldn't that be sharp and cute? And plus, my husband Jay, I apparently had a red skirt years ago, and he mentioned it, and I kind of forgot about it. So I thought, oh, wouldn't it be cute to turn up in a red skirt? So that was part of what inspired the red suit. And I thought I had another skirt as well in there. With all these clothes that I'm buying, this is just a hanger set that I intend to use in an effort to organize said clothing a little better. I thought this one looked kind of neat because I do wear a lot of tank tops, so you can hang them like that. I think I have another one that's kind of that idea. Huh, a little bit gimpy here. This one here I see is sort of, oh, I see they swing back and forth. So I think really probably what this would be more meant for is hanging perhaps a skirt on each of the levels like so. Yeah, I think that's what I had in mind perhaps. Because you can, you know, getting five skirts like this, and plus, here's the other thing, being able to see them, because I do have some skirts that I have folded up and piled on each other, well, in that armoire that I can't see and with the, that I'm going to be using the light bars for, but I also have a separate rack, you know, hanging rack, so I don't know, I think this will probably work out pretty good for five. I think this one was in the ballpark of $7. I mean, some of these items, I have to say, Temu is going, I've noticed their prices are, you know, gradually increasing. I mean, gone are the days of the, like, you know, 9 cents for this, the, you know, 18 cents for that. You know, you might see one or two items like that floating around, but, you know, Temu is, I mean, it's kind of like a dollar store at this point. So, you know, I have been losing interest in it. It's just the draw that they have is that if you're just sitting there waiting and you got a couple of minutes to kill, it is fun to go and browse at their junk. And it's just so easy to fill stuff in your cart. And, you know, Temu knows what they're doing with these credits and stuff. You know, they do make the return so easy. And then encourage getting, you know, the in-store credit, and then, well, not in-store, you know what I mean, and the online credits, and keeps you coming back for more and more, because you're going to keep using them up. So, anyways, you're not here for a lesson on economics. We're here to take a look at my Temu goodies. So, yes, I'm looking forward to this. I think this one might be a good find, this here, skirt hanger is what it will be used best for. So that's our plan for that. Oh, and then this one here, such a silly thing, but you know, I'm embarrassed to admit it, but I know for a fact I am not the only person who does this. And when I'm in the shower, like if I'm listening to a podcast or a show or something, and I have been guilty of putting my phone in a Ziploc bag and propping it up and listening to the rest of my show while I take my shower. So I got one of these actual pouches that they use at water parks. I've seen these at water parks before where they'll just wear them around their neck and they're completely submerged in water. So I'm not looking to submerge my phone in water just, you know, to keep some of the splatter off. So this was 77 cents, so not too bad. I mean, basically what I did was paid 77 cents for a plastic baggie. I paid 77 cents for an item that does exactly what a baggie does that's sitting downstairs, but I don't know, I thought that the rope was, I wanted it, okay? I wanted it. 77 cents. But I'll try it out. I mean, it better have a good seal, because even at 77 cents, you know, I can return it if I'm not going to use it. All right, let's see what this one here is. Oh, okay, this one I was excited about, a black blazer. Just a plain black blazer. It's a, you know, kind of thin, not the highest quality material you'll find. Again, a little bit of that scratchy-ish feeling material, like the red. Well, actually, the red one I would say is slightly softer, but yeah, it's that polyester material. You know, not bad or anything like that by any means, but it's certainly not like, you know, nice soft fleecy either. But this one here, it was under $10. It's a large. It seems so big. So big. But I am a little bit more on the broad shoulder side for a girl. But, well, and I've got a sweater on right now. Yeah, it is a little on the big side. But, you know, as a large, I mean, going down to a medium, I don't know. It's hard to say. It's big. But we'll have to think about it. And I think it was under $10, so it's really not that bad.